Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick from educates.tv, and today we are going to see how to develop our first graphical user interface in order to control the GPIO pins of our Raspberry Pi. Without any further delay, let's get started. The project we are building today is very simple but very useful. As you can see, I am using an application that I have developed to turn on or off the LED simply by touching an on-screen button. In this video, we are going to see how to develop an application like this, and as you are going to find out, it is extremely easy. The hardware setup of today's project is this. I am using a Raspberry Pi A+, but you can use any Raspberry Pi you want that has 40 GPIO pins. I am also using a 5-inch touch display from Waveshare. I have prepared a detailed tutorial on that display a few weeks ago. You can check it out. If you don't have a touch display, the graphical user interface we are developing will work fine with a mouse as well. I have connected the positive leg of the LED via a 100 ohm resistor to GPIO pin 40 of the Raspberry Pi. The other leg of the resistor is connected to GPIO pin 39, which is ground. The pins of the Raspberry Pi use 3.3 volt logic levels, unlike Arduino, which uses 5 volts. Have that in mind. Then I connect the screen and we boot up the Raspberry Pi. All we have to do now is to run the simple Python program I have developed using the TkInter library. The program is located on the desktop, so I run the following commands in order to run it. Cd desktop and sudo python gui.py, and I press enter. That's it, the graphical user interface has appeared, and when I press the button the LED lights up, and when I press it again it goes off. When I press the exit button, the application quits. Now that we know how to run the application, let's see the code of it. In order to develop this graphical user interface, we are going to use the TkInter library. It is the most commonly used library for Python to develop graphical user interfaces. It is already included in your Raspberry Pi distribution, so you don't have to download anything at all. As you can see, the code of the project is simple and small. We only need 37 lines of code. At first, I configure pin 40 to act as an output and I set it to low. Next, I create our main window. The next command creates a font for the text that we are going to use. After that, there are two functions that I am going to explain later. With these two commands, we set the title of the main window that we created and the dimensions on the screen. With the next two commands, we create the exit button and we declare that when it is pressed, we want to execute the exit program function. With the same technique, we create the LED button, which when pressed executes the LED on function. The LED on function checks the state of pin 40 of the Raspberry Pi port. If it is high, it makes it low, else if it is low, it makes it high. The exit program function, when executed, it simply exits the program. As you can see, the code is very simple and you can easily modify it in order to fit your needs. You can download the code in a link in the description of the video. You can control anything with it, and having on-screen controls make things so much easier. That's today's project. I hope that you find it useful. Are you going to use TkInter to make your own graphical user interfaces in order to control your projects? Please post any project ideas in the comment section below. If you are new to the channel, you may not know that my day job is developing Android games, and last week I published a new game to Google Play Store. It is called Quiz of Knowledge, and it is a quiz game that supports 5 languages and it is completely free. If you like quiz games, I am sure you are going to enjoy this one. If you wish, you can download it by clicking here or in a link in the description of the video. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about Arduino, Raspberry Pi, and robot projects every Saturday. I love teaching what I know and sharing my experience with you. That's why I created this channel. I hope you will join our community. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.